Hey, Mark here. Today I'm going to describe what it's like to drive my 2022 Slingshot S. Now, you don't need a special license to drive the Slingshot. All you need is a regular license. In Tennessee, I do have to wear a helmet. It's kind of strange because if I had a full roll cage or a full roof cage on my Slingshot, I wouldn't have to wear a helmet. But since I don't have the roll cage, I do have to wear a helmet. The Slingshot has real aggressive styling, which Polaris has said that they styled it after a predatory bird like an eagle or a hawk or something. It has two wheels in the front and a single wheel on a swing arm in the rear. It has large storage compartments behind both seats and a large glove box. It also has an electronic proximity key fob, which means I just have to have the key fob in my pocket and just push the starter button when I'm in the driver's seat. The Slingshot first came out in 2014 for the 2015 model year, but in 2020 it got a major overhaul so that 75% of its parts are not interchangeable. It has a 2-liter double overhead cam liquid cooled inline 4-cylinder engine and a 5-speed transmission. It did have, previously, before 2020, a GM Ecotec 2.5-liter engine. It has a GM 5-speed, which is the same transmission that was used in the Chevy Colorado truck and the Isuzu Trooper. The transmission shifts very well with short, precise throws. It clicks firmly into the gears and it's very positive shifts. Getting in the Slingshot, it has no doors, but it has these frame rails that run on each side, so it's a little bit of a job getting into the seat. If you have limited mobility, it would be very difficult to get in the Slingshot. Front brakes are single piston calipers with 18 by 7.5-inch rims mounted on the front. On the back, it's also a single piston caliper with a 20-inch by 9-inch rear wheel. The driver's seat moves forward and backward, and the steering column tilts up and down. Driving the Slingshot is a fun and lively experience. It's almost like a go-kart. Handling is very lively and responsive. It feels like there's good front grip when turning. It has a nice, low-slung convertible feeling. There's 4 inches of suspension travel, front and rear. The engine has a good sound. It's fun to shift up through the gears. Below 60 miles an hour, it handles quite nicely. But because of the stiff suspension, above 60 miles an hour and on rough roads, things can be a little rough. The Slingshot is at its best on curvy back roads cruising around 40 to 45 miles an hour. Traction control helps a lot with getting the power to the rear wheel, but it is possible to spin the rear tire even with the traction control on. The traction control can be turned off if you want to do slides or donuts and that kind of stuff. The brakes work good, not great. They take a lot of pedal pressure to stop the vehicle. The Slingshot does feature anti-lock brakes. Fuel capacity is 9 3/4 gallons for a range of about 250 to 300 miles. The dash has an analog speedometer and analog tachometer, along with a digital display for fuel, mileage, odometer, charging, and the temperature. It also can display ambient temperature, time, and trip 1 and trip 2. My Slingshot is the S trim level, which is the base level. My Slingshot has cruise control, which works great, and a Rockford Fosgate sound system, which sounds good. It's worth noting that because the Slingshot is classified as an auto cycle, it does not have energy absorbing body panels or airbags like a car. Its only safety equipment is seat belts and roll bars. It's also worth noting that the Slingshot has 4 power outlets for your phone or whatever you want to charge. There's one in the glove box, one in the center console, and 2 between the seats. So that's what it's like to drive the Polaris Slingshot. Hope you enjoyed the ride. Bye.